Yeah, well, I was really enthusiastic about this job, which is why I asked to come here. I have worked in other places that are pretty warm. New Delhi, I was there for 4 years. It was also about 40 degrees some of the time. But I find the Caribbean area is really interesting. The overseas territory relationship that we have between the United Kingdom and Cayman is a very important one. Cayman is the most populous of all of our overseas territories, and of course a very successful one, and also a most beautiful set of islands, which I'm hoping to be able to support as we protect and develop them. So right from the very start, I felt I had a very, very warm welcome. It was really wonderful that so many people and members indeed of the government, including the Honourable Premier, turned up at the airport to say hello to me when I landed on Friday the 21st. And then I met a lot of other people at the most beautiful Pedro St. James, where we had the reception the following evening. But since then, I have chaired cabinet twice, so it's been very important to me to get to know all of the members of the government. And I've also been to various events, visited the sister islands, and really felt the warmth of the Cayman kind reception that I've had. So I think these islands are beautiful, but the most beautiful thing about them is the people. Yes, that was very important to me to get out to the sister islands, because, you know, Cayman is three islands, so you can't just spend, you know, come to Grand Cayman and think you've seen it all. And it was just beautiful going out to Little Cayman and Cayman Brac. I was able to attend the agriculture show on Little Cayman, very important, and a lot of effort being made to encourage people to do their own gardening, grow their own vegetables. It's quite inspiring, actually. I also went to the museum, where I was able to see the rather old uniform that I note that all of these previous male governors were required to wear. So I have to say I was quite relieved that I no longer have to wear that. But it was amazing to see it there in the museum, and it was very impressive. And I also saw the National Trust and the Marine Institute, which is a great mixture of both research and education of our young people, which is really important. Yes, I mean, anyone who's been here would appreciate that the minute you walk in, you just really cannot believe how beautiful it is. And that very evening, we had a particularly beautiful sunset, so I still have photos on my telephone, and I was showing them to all my friends and family back home, and they really couldn't believe it. And then the next morning, I got up very early and went for a walk on the beach with the dog, and then went swimming, and the dog was able to go swimming in the sea, so he can't believe how lucky he is. Though I have to say, when he comes back to the house, he's very, very sandy, because he somehow always insists on rolling in the sand after he's been in the water. So there's then a big showering job that needs to be done before he comes back in the house. Yeah, so my husband, Dave, died of cancer about 6 years ago, actually, which was a really hard time for the family and a really sad time for us. And I guess it means that I'm quite interested in, you know, supporting the hospice and supporting charities that are looking at families going through that kind of thing. But we have two wonderful children, Phoebe, who's 23, who's here with me at the moment. She's been helping me unpack. And James, who's just finishing his degree in East Anglia in Norwich. He's doing computer science, and he's going to be coming over in about 6 weeks' time, I think, to spend some of the summer here. So he's really looking forward to that as well. It's a very important moment, I think, for the United Kingdom. It feels like a transition from the time of the era of Her Late Majesty to now King Charles III. I think the King is very inspirational in many areas, including the environment, actually, and he's really committed to our relationships with the overseas territories. I know he was here not so long ago in 2019, and I'm very pleased, therefore, that the Premier and I will have an opportunity to talk to His Majesty and other members of the Royal Family, as well as the British Government, about how we make sure that this wonderful and important relationship we have is really fit for the future, and that we're all putting in place the building blocks to make it continue to be successful and beneficial for both sides. Well, I'd just like to say to all of your listeners and viewers that it's a great pleasure to be able to reach out to everyone. I feel very privileged and humbled to be here in this role, and I'm here to listen and to learn. So I hope to be doing a lot more of that as soon as I get back with Premier Panton from the coronation and the Joint Ministerial Council, which is this round table that we have with all of the overseas territories and British ministers and representatives from across Whitehall, across the British government. So that will be a really important thing that we're doing, and hopefully come back with some useful actions for the future.